Hello and welcome back to the Investing 365 channel. I'm sure you're keeping up with the times of what's going on with the stock market, Wall Street Bets, Reddit, all those things. And today I wanted to simplify everything that's been going on and tell you exactly up to date my opinions on the matter, but more importantly, the actual facts of what's happening. These events have been going on for the last 2 weeks up until the time I'm making this video. And in order to know what's happening and why it's happening, you need to know how it all started. So how this all started is by what's called a short squeeze. And when it comes to GameStop and a few of these other companies, essentially what was happening were big boy hedge fund managers like Melvin Capital and Citron have been shorting stocks like GameStop and a few others for quite some time. Because again, the fundamentals just really aren't there for some of these stocks like AMC, GameStop, Express, and any other stock that's pretty much climbed 400, 500, 600% in the last few weeks. And to briefly explain what a short is when you bet against the stock, thinking that the stock price is actually gonna go down. And during this short, the people of Wall Street Bets said, screw it, we're gonna bet against these whales and place bets against your bets, meaning we're gonna bet the stock price goes up and not down. They bought so many shares of the stock that it put pressure on these hedge fund managers, essentially squeezing their short, and now they are having to cover their overall position. Now, what happened more recently in the last couple of days, a lot of brokerages, including Robinhood, TD Ameritrade, Charles Schwab, and even M1 Finance, had to pause trading for most of these stocks on Thursday, but not completely. And this is where they got caught with their pants down. They told their retail investors, people like you and I, that they could only sell their positions in these stocks, and they wouldn't let you buy any more positions in these stocks, meaning the price of the stocks are ultimately gonna go down because of all the sell pressure. And this price action for all these investors that are invested in these companies, and the fact that Robinhood and other platforms started to restrict the ability to buy more stocks, buy more options, this caused an outrage to the Wall Street Bets community and over half of the overall Robinhood community as well. And strangely enough, during all of this, there have also been reports of the big investors, the whales of it all, with millions of dollars that could actually buy and sell their positions. So that's really problem one and two. Now, problem number three is really interesting. The fact that retail investors like you and I could not buy more shares, this caused the price to crash over 50% for most of these companies. Due to this fact, most people went ahead and started to leave one-star reviews on the App Store, Google Play Store, on apps like Robinhood, TD Ameritrade, and countless others. And a lot of people even started to rage on platforms like Twitter, Reddit, the YouTube comment section, Instagram, Facebook, and many other social media platforms. Not to even mention the fact that other big names, very, very important people like AOC, Elon Musk, Tyler Winklevoss, were calling out these big platforms and saying that this is absolutely market manipulation created by these financial institutions. And this even caused Robinhood to publish a statement a few hours back, because I wouldn't be surprised that they have a few lawsuits coming their way. Now, here's a final and very, very important part to this whole overall equation. Robinhood doesn't actually fulfill their stock orders, but instead a company called Citadel does. And the interesting thing is, Citadel is actually heavily invested in Melvin Capital. We're talking billions of dollars, which is the same company that's losing billions, especially when it comes to GameStop. It's theorized that maybe Citadel had stopped the order flow for Robinhood, and for Citadel, it might be cheaper to have a class action lawsuit against them versus letting people actually trade and pump up the price of GameStop and these other stocks even higher. Because if that were to happen, they would lose more and more money on the way up. So like I mentioned before, Robinhood had finally sent out a letter to all of their investors because so many people are threatening and already left the Robinhood platform and even threatening to sue Robinhood, saying in the statement that they are going to resume trading in these stocks sometime tomorrow. It sounds like to me, Robinhood doesn't really know what to do and may be responsible for some of this mess. It's interesting because Robinhood maybe trying to kiss the SEC's, Citadel's, and the Robinhood users' butts all at the same time, which is hard to do. And all of this will probably cause a lot of trouble, not only for Robinhood and these financial institutions that also followed suit, but also for Citadel as well. It will be very, very interesting to see how all this ends up playing out. And whatever happens, I'll probably be moving the majority of my money, if not all of my money, to other platforms like Webull and Fidelity as well. In my opinion, This is just a big classic battle of rich versus the poor. And as of right now, it doesn't look like Robinhood is fighting on the side that they said that they would be on. We'll have to see what ends up happening. Either way, whatever does end up happening, I hope you enjoyed this market update. And if you have any further questions that I might have not answered in this video, feel free to leave them down in the comment section below. Don't forget to like this video if you haven't already, so more people can get access to this. Feel free to share it with a friend. And last but not least, don't forget to subscribe if this is your first time to the channel. Thank you all so much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next episode. Peace out. Feel free to check out the links down in the description below where you can get $20 free from Stash, 2 or more stocks free from Webull, or $10 free from M1 Finance.